Hello everyone. Today our topic is cocktail sorting algorithm. Cocktail sorting is a variation of bubble sort. In bubble sort, we traverse the array elements from left to right. After each iteration, the largest element in the remaining subarray is placed at the end of the subarray. So in the first scan, we will have the largest element here, and in the next scan, this array element will not participate in the compare swap process. After the second scan, we'll have the second largest element here, and again, it will not participate in the compare swap process in the next scan. Cocktail sort traverses through a given array in both directions alternatively. Each iteration of the algorithm is broken into two stages. The first stage loops through the array from left to right, as the case in bubble sort. During the loop, adjacent elements are compared and swapped as necessary. So after this stage, we'll have the largest element at the end of the array. The second stage loops through the array elements in the opposite direction. Here we have to start from the item just before the most recently sorted item. So in each iteration, we perform these two stages. So after some iterations, we'll have these elements sorted and this part also sorted. So we need to scan only through this part. So the size of the middle part is reduced by two elements in each iteration, one from the right and one from the left. So initially we set the array index to start, for example, and the index here to end. After the first stage of each iteration, the end index is reduced by one. And after the second stage of each iteration, the start index is incremented by one. Another improvement can be made. We can set a logical variable, for example, not sorted to true, and loop while not sorted is true. If during any iteration, no swaps are performed, the not sorted is switched to false and we can break. So in this case, we do not need to perform all the iterations, and this will reduce the algorithm complexity. Here we have the Python program for the cocktail sorting algorithm. Suppose that this is our array A. Now we can call the cocktail sort function A here. Len is the array length. Not sorted equals true. Start index 0. End index n minus 1. In the external loop, while not sorted is true, we set not sorted to false. Next, we loop from start to end and compare and swap the adjacent elements. If any swap is performed, we set not sorted to true. After completing this scan from left to right, we check if not sorted equal false, then we break. Otherwise, we start the scan from right to left. We set not sorted to false. End is decremented by one. And now we loop from end minus one to start minus one with the step minus one. Again, we compare and swap the adjacent elements. If we swap any two elements, not sorted is set to true. After that, start index is incremented by one. And we loop again while not sorted is true. After completing, the sorted array is retained. Now we can print it for I in range len array print AI. So if we run the program, we'll have here the array sorted in ascending order. The time complexity of the cocktail sort is big O in square. Time complexity is the same as in bubble sort, but cocktail sort performs better than bubble sort. Typically, cocktail sort is less than 2 times faster than bubble sort. Although the improvement over bubble sort is insignificant, but it can be useful in some applications. Again, the main idea in cocktail sort that we scan the array in both directions. From left to right in each iteration, we find the next largest, and from right to left, we find the next smallest element in the subarray. The found so far largest and the smallest elements will not participate in the next iterations. So in each iteration, the number of swap compare operations is reduced by two. And therefore, the number of total swaps for today, that's all. Thank you.